I'm going to do a real quick demo of how to create a Google form and then how to put conditional formatting in it. So I'm here in my Google Drive, and I'm going to, because I am such a fan of folders and subfolders, I'm going to go into the place that I want to be, and I'm going to create new, and then I'm going to go down to more, and I'm going to click Google Forms. So here we are. I'm going to give this a name. This one is going to be called Basic Form and Auto Format. Just click OK. And I'm just going to do the basic things. So some basic addition and subtraction. And then because it's multiple choice, I'm going to just give it a couple of answers. Whenever I want to add in another option, I'll hit add item over here. But you see here, I've got option 5. I'm going to come up and edit this and then click X to get off of that. Now I'll hit done again. And then where it says add item, I can choose if I want this to be text, paragraph text, multiple choice, or so on. I'm going to choose text for this one. Because it's text, I am not going to type in anything. I'm just going to hit done. And I'm just going to add one more. For checkboxes, I'm going to ask something that has nothing to do with addition, subtraction. Kids could choose as many as they like here. I'm just hitting tab to go through here and add the other options. I can copy and paste items in a list, and then it will automatically go in there for me, so that way I don't have to hit tab and add each one in. Okay, so whenever I want to give this form to my students, I can come over here and hit send form, and it will send to their email and embed in there for them. I'm not going to do that for this one because I want us to be able to see what it's going to look like. So I'm just going to go to view live form. And I am going to just take my quiz very quickly. And then I'll hit submit, and I'm going to close that tab. Now, I'm going to go over here to view responses, so that way we can see what this looks like. There's my answers. Okay, notice that it's going to timestamp that for me. So I'm going to come over here to the how are you feeling today question. I'm going to click on this drop down right here, and I'm going to scroll down where it says conditional formatting. Click on that, and if the text contains, I'm going to say angry, I want to change my background color to red. Okay, and then let's add another rule. If my text is exactly happy, I want my background color to change to yellow. And then I'm going to hit save rules. Okay, so see, it changed my column right here to happy. I'm going to go back in, view my form again. I'm going to take it one more time. And this time I'm going to say angry and hit submit. And go in here, and then you can see. So as a teacher, I can very easily look at this and see what's going on with my kids. So I could have put that conditional formatting over here on these answers, So that way I could have been able to tell very quickly if they understand or not just by looking at the color coding. So you can do this on any sheets. It does not have to be a part of a form. Any sheets in Google can have the conditional formatting. It's a great visual tool. If you're a visual person that likes to color code things, I would highly suggest it. So that's your little tip for today. Hope you enjoyed.